Good morning, Heidi. It appears that this convoy is set to begin any time now. I can tell you that there is a lot of activity out here. Take a look right across the way here. This is the entrance to the Jackson family compound. You can see that there are police who are staged right in front of it. Up above, there is a CHP helicopter, news choppers that are flying overhead. The road that comes into this home has been closed down. The only people who have been allowed to come close to the house are the fans that you see there behind the barriers. Many of these people have been here for the last 4 or 5 hours. We've seen this steady flow of SUVs and limos and Rolls Royces that have entered the compound. We've also seen this very large convoy of unmarked Range Rovers and Escalades that have been parked. We were told
Naples Center.
I gotta say, it's stunning to suddenly see the casket.
It was a little bit of a surprise. I mean, it is one of those senses that, wow, he's really dead. Around us has been pictures all day of a young Michael Jackson, and then through his career. But to see these pictures of Forest Lawn Cemetery and the body of Michael Jackson being loaded into the back of the hearse really is a certain amount of finality.
Brian Monroe, formerly with Ebony and Jet magazine, you had the last interview with Michael Jackson. Your thoughts on seeing this?
Well, you know, watching to see who the pallbearers are. It looks like several members, several brothers are helping out. You know, it's sad, but it's also, this tribute is going to be phenomenal today. I understand inside the Staples Center is going to have a very solemn and serious tone, and will be both a memorial and a funeral. It's not a lot of pomp and circumstance, but we'll remember him in a very somber way.
Since news came out that Michael Jackson's body would be moving in a motorcade, you can imagine that people are coming out of their homes now. What the most likely route is going to be here is that this hearse and the motorcade will take a right-hand turn on a Forest Lawn, and they will go through the Griffith Park area. And a number of people have now gathered at the Griffith Park area. From there, they'll pick up most likely to the 5 freeway and then down to the 110, which will take you directly down into downtown. But already, with just in the last 10 to 15 minutes, we've seen a lot more people coming out of their homes, hoping, obviously, to get a glimpse of this procession as it goes by and makes its way into downtown Los Angeles.
Hillary Rosen is also joining us, former president of the Recording Industry of America. Hillary, you're also hearing about a number of songs that are going to be performed at the celebration.
Mariah Carey is going to sing I'll Be There. Stevie Wonder is going to sing I Never Dreamed I'd Leave You in Summer, a beautiful song. Jennifer Hudson will sing Will You Be There. Chris Brown is there. Akon is there. And, you know, Akon actually did the last duet with Michael Jackson and want to be starting something. Michael Jackson's most recent charting single was with Akon, so I think we could expect to see that. And then Lionel Richie, all of the artists have been asked to stay and perform with Lionel Richie at the end to do a star-studded We Are the World.
Thank you.